In the last video, we discussed the importance of transportation, then the various modes of transportation in which roadways, railways, airways and waterways. Okay, now in this video, we will discuss about general classification of road, then the classification of road according to Nagpur Road Development Plan and the Lucknow Road Plan. Okay, so let's start the video. Now we see the general classification of roads. The roads are classified on the following basis. So first is according to traffic. Then second classification is according to transported tonnage. Then the third classification is according to importance. And fourth classification is according to location and its function. Okay. The general classification means the roads classified according to its physical characteristics or its appearance and function. Now we can discuss the general classification of road. So these are the four classification of roads. In next slide we discuss one by one in detail. So first classification is according to traffic. The roads are classified into four different categories according to traffic. So here this column shows the types of road and this column shows the vehicles per day. Okay, so the first type of road is very heavy traffic road. For this, vehicles per day are above 600. For the heavy, very heavy traffic roads, vehicles per day are above 600. Okay. Then the second type of road is heavy traffic road. For these, vehicles are 251 to 600. Okay. The second type is heavy traffic roads. For this, vehicles are in between 251 to 600 per day. Then the third type of road is medium traffic roads. For these, vehicles are in between 70 to 250. Then the fourth type of road is light traffic roads. For these, vehicles are below 70. Okay, for these type of road, vehicles per day are below 70. Okay, so from this table you can easily understand the classification according to traffic. Now we see the second classification, that is according to tonnage. Okay, this table shows the classification according to table. Here the type of road is very heavy traffic road. For the very heavy traffic road, the vehicles per day are above 1525. Okay. For very heavy traffic roads, the vehicles are above 1525. For a day on or per day, then this road is called as very heavy traffic road. Then the second type is heavy traffic roads. So the vehicles are 1017 to 1524. That is, the vehicles are in between 1017 to 1524. Then this type of road is called as heavy traffic road. Okay. Then the third is medium traffic roads. The vehicles per day are in between 508 to 1017. Then the type of road is medium traffic road. Then the fourth type of road is light traffic road. The vehicles are below 508. The vehicles are below 508. Then the type of road is light traffic roads. Okay. So from this table you can easily understand the classification according to tonnage. Then the third classification is according to importance. According to importance of connecting holy places, stations of strategic importance, roads are classified as three categories. That is, class 1 roads, then second is class 2 roads, and third is class 3 roads. Okay. So, class 1 roads means the roads which is clean and well. The road who fulfilled all the requirements of first class, that road is called as first class road. Okay. Then the second class road or class 2 roads means the road is similar to class 1 road, but the minor difference in this road means the quality of this road is medium. So that's why it is called as class 2 roads. Okay. Then the third is class 3 roads. Means the road which does not fulfill the requirements of quality road, that road is called as class 3 roads. So these are the three classification according to importance of roads: class 1 road, class 2 road, and class 3 roads. Now the next classification is according to location and its function. Okay. According to location and function, roads are classified as first national highways, then second state highways, then third major district road, then fourth other district road, and fifth village road. Okay, so first national highway. It is the main highway running through the breadth and length of the country and joining the major parts of country is called as national highway. The main highway running through the breadth and length of the country. Okay, then the second is state highways. The state highways are linking up with the national highways of adjacent state. Okay, then the third is major district road. Major district roads are important roads within the district that serving areas of production and markets and collecting their places with each other. Okay, then the fourth is other district road. The other district road means the roads serving rural areas of production and providing them with outlet to market centers. Okay, and the last is village road. Village road means the roads connecting villages or group of villages. So these are the classification according to location and its functions. Then the next classification is based on traffic type. Based on traffic type, roads are classified into three categories, that is pedestrian ways, then second cycle tracks, and third motor ways. Okay. The first is pedestrian ways, means the people use this road for walk or ways to the walk. Okay. Then the second is cycle track. Cycle track means the roads which are used for cycles, and the last one is motorways. Motorways means the roads are used for traveling with motors. So these are the general classification of roads. Now our next point is Nagpur road plan. First we discuss what is Nagpur road plan. This plan is executed in the year 1943. Okay, this plan is executed in the year 1943. In the year 1943, the conference of chief engineers of central and state governments at Nagpur formulated a balanced system of road development plan for the country. It's called as Nagpur plan. This plan is also called as IRC classification of roads. IRC means Indian Road Congress. So So according to this plan, the following are the classification of Nagpur Road plan. So we see the classification of Nagpur Road plan. The first classification is national highways. Then second is state highways. Then third is major district road. Then fourth, other district road. And fifth, village road. So we discuss one by one in detail. According to Nagpur Road plan, the first classification is national highways. Okay, so what is the national highway? The main highways running through the length and breadth of India, joining major parts, capital of states, large industrial and tourist centers, foreign highways, including roads required for strategic movements for the defense of India, etc., are known as national highways. Means the highways which joining the major parts of country as well as the capital of states and also joining the foreign highways. Okay, so it is called as national highways. The road width varies from national highway is 7 meter to 15 meter. Then the responsibility of construction and maintenance of these roads lies with central government. Then according to Nagpur Road plan, all national highways are assigned with respective numbers. Okay, all national highways are assigned with respective numbers. So capital NH1, okay, capital NH1, this road, this national highway is known as Delhi Chandigarh Amritsar road. Okay, NH1 means Delhi Chandigarh Amritsar road. Then NH2, national highway 2, is Delhi Agra Kanpur Kolkata road. Then NH3, national highway 3, means Mumbai Nashik Agra road. Then according to Nagpur Road plan, the second classification is state highways. So what is state highway? The highways which link the capital of the state to important cities within the state and connect them with national highways are known as state highways. Means these are the highways which join or link with the important cities of state and also connect the cities to national highway. Okay, the geometric design, specification and design speed for national highway and state highway are same. The road width varies from 7 meter to 10 meter. The road width of state highway varies from 7 meter to 10 meter. And the responsibility of construction and maintenance of these roads lies with state government. Okay, the responsibility of construction and maintenance of these roads lies with state government. Then the third classification is major district roads, that is MDR. So major district road means the important roads within a district serving areas of production and markets and connecting these places with each other or with the main highways are known as major district roads. Means these are the roads which connect each district place to the taluka place. Okay, these are the roads which connects each district place to the taluka place. The responsibility of construction and maintenance of these roads lies with district authorities. The responsibility of these roads lies with district authorities. Then the width of these roads varies from 5 meter to 8 meter. Then the next classification according to Nagpur Road plan is other district roads, that is ODR. So what is other district roads? The roads serving rural areas of production and providing them with outlet to market centers, tehsil headquarters, railway stations, etc. are known as other district roads. Means major district roads having lower specification serving areas of production, railway stations as well as market centers. These roads have lower design specification than major district roads. Okay, these roads should have single lane width of at least stabilized soil or water bound macadam surface. Then the next classification is village road. So what is village road? The roads connecting villages or group of villages with each other or with the nearest road of higher category are known as village roads. Means the roads which connects the village to the nearest highways. These roads are very important from the rural area development point of view. So the responsibility of construction and maintenance of these roads lies with local district authorities. So these are the various classification of roads according to Nagpur Road Plan. Then the next point we will see is third road development plan. Okay. This is the modified classification of road. Okay. This road is also called as Lucknow Road Plan. This plan or this development plan was the third 20-year road plan, that is 1981 to 2001. Okay. It is also called as Lucknow Road Plan. Then next point is classification of road system. There are three classification of road system, that is first is primary system, then second is secondary system and third is tertiary system. In primary system there are two subcategories, that is first is expressways and second is national highways. Then in secondary system there are also two categories, first is state highways and second is major district road. In tertiary system there are also two categories, first is other district road, then second is village road. So now let's discuss about expressways. So what is expressways? Expressways are a separate class of highways with superior facilities and design standard and are meant as through roads having very high volume of traffic. Means these are the separate class of highways. In this, the superior facilities are provided. Also, the design of these highways are very standard. The traffic volume of these highways are very high as compared to other highways. These highways should permit only fast moving vehicles. Only fast moving vehicles are permitted for these highways. Then the other classification of road system, that is national highways, then state highways, major district road, other district road and village road, are similar to the classification according to Nagpur Road Plan. So all these classification are already discussed in Nagpur Road Plan. Hope you like the information given in this video. We had discussed in this video is about the classification or general classification of roads, then Nagpur Road Plan, then modified road plan. Okay, up to this, if anybody have any question or problem, then please ask me and complete the assignments which are allotted to you. Okay, thank you.